Good morning, class 12. Today I am going to start with Indian Economic Development, where under Unit 1, that is Development Policies and Experiences, you will be doing chapter Indian Economy on the Eve of Independence. Well, children, the basic aim of this chapter is to familiarize you with the basic features of the Indian economy and its development as you see today after the independence. But before that, you must know that the kind of an economy which we have today is not the result of a current making, children, but it is because of the events which happened in a past, and let's say particularly in the period when India was ruled by Britishers. You all know that Britishers, they ruled us for almost 2 centuries, and ultimately on 15th August 1947 we got the independence. Children, do you know that when Britishers were ruling us, then their main purpose of this colonial rule in India was merely to bring our country a supplier of raw material for Great Britain, because Britishers, they were more interested in expanding their modern industrial base in their own country, that is Britain. So to make their country progress, to make the economy to rise, they made our country simply a country of a supplier of raw material. So children, under this chapter, the topics which we will be covering are, the very first is low level of economic development under the colonial rule. Then you will be learning about agriculture sector, then industrial sector, foreign trade, next demographic condition, then occupational structure, and the last will be the infrastructure. So children, let's start with the first topic, a subtopic, that is the low level of economic development under the colonial rule. Now you can understand low level of economic development. If it is written, it means that under the colonial rule, you know, colonial rule means when some powerful country tries to dominate the other country. So over here, Britishers, they were, in fact, they dominated India. So when they dominated our country, so the economic condition of a country deteriorated. Do you know, there was a time when India was an independent country. Our economy was an independent economy before Britishers, they came to our country. And agriculture was the main source of livelihood of the people. You know, that was the time that maximum people, they were engaged in number of manufacturing activities like handicraft industries, then cotton and silk textile, metal, precious stones, and so on. So children, that was the time when the products of a country were in worldwide demand. Throughout the world, people demanded our products. The reason, because of the fine quality material which was used by us, and of course the high standards of craftsmanship that was seen by the people throughout the world. So before Britishers came, our country was self-sufficient. But when these people, they came, then they were more interested in making their country more rich, in making their economy to be expanded. So the economic policies which this colonial government they implemented in our country was never for the protection and promotion of the, let's say, the economic interest of their of our country, but they were more interested to frame such policies in our country which would promote the economic interest of their own country. So children, such policies, they brought a large change in the Indian economy, which made our country into a supplier of raw material and of course a consumer of finished industrial products from Britain. Means these Britishers, they made our country simply the supplier of raw material. They used to take raw material from our country, convert it into a finished good in their country, and that finished good was sold in our country, and the people of our country had to purchase those goods. So you can imagine, the colonial government, they were never ever interested in making a sincere attempt, let's say, to estimate the national income of our country and per capita income of our country. They never made any attempts to increase it, or rather to estimate it. Though there were some of the notable estimators who tried to estimate, among them were like Dada Bhai Naroji, then William Digboy, Findlay Shiras, then V.K.R.V. Rao and R.C. Desai. And among all children, it was V.K.R.V. Roy whose estimate during the colonial period was considered a very significant. The reason, because most studies did not find that country's growth and aggregate real output, you know, during the first half of the 20th century was less than 2% children. So that was the time when Britishers, they never made any attempt to improvise the economy of our country. Rather, they made all the attempts to improve the economy of their home country, that is Britain.